Hi everybody and welcome back. Today we're going to be making tetrabutylammonium hexamolybdate, an interesting yellow polyoxometallate salt.
For this experiment you will need acetone, tetrabutylammonium bromide, sodium molybdate dihydrate, and 20% hydrochloric acid.
So without further ado, let's get into it. First, 5 grams of sodium molybdate dihydrate is dissolved in 20 milliliters of water. Next, in a test tube, a solution of 2.42 grams of tetrabutylammonium bromide and 5 milliliters of water is prepared. Next, 6.64 milliliters of 20% hydrochloric acid is slowly poured in over the course of around a minute. A P1000 micropipetter is used to assist in this. The tetrabutylammonium bromide solution is pipetted in, forming a curdy white precipitate of tetrabutylammonium octamolybdate. The flask is swirled and then heated to 75 to 80 degrees Celsius for an hour with stirring. I initially used a water bath for this, then switched to the hot plate after I realized that I couldn't stir through the water bath. Over this time, the precipitate color changes from white to the characteristic yellow of our product. While that heats up, I think I'll talk about the reaction mechanism. But before I begin, please keep in mind that I'm not an experienced polyoxometallate chemist, so I might be making some mistakes here. But without further ado, let's get into that. First, in aqueous solution, the molybdate anion reacts with an acid to form molybdic acid, which is a hydrated form of molybdenum trioxide. Next, a reaction called elation occurs. In the acidic aqueous solution, molybdic acid reacts with itself, forming a mixture of polymeric oxides. However, the main one formed is the octamolybdate anion, which is a cluster composed of MOO4 tetrahedra and MOO6 octahedra. When the tetrabutylammonium bromide solution is added, it shifts out any other cations, forming a mixture of tetrabutylammonium polyoxometallates. The major one formed, however, is a water-insoluble white precipitate of tetrabutylammonium octamolybdate. When the mixture is heated, the complicated mixture of polyoxometallate anions combines, forming the hexamolybdate anion, which forms a yellow solid in the reaction. And that completes the mechanism, so let's get back to the reaction. Once this is complete, the yellowish tetrabutylammonium hexamolybdate precipitate is filtered off and then washed with 3 20 milliliter portions of room temperature distilled water. I obtained about 5 grams of a damp, greenish-yellow crude product. The crude product is then recrystallized from 120 milliliters of boiling acetone. A small amount of unreacted tetrabutylammonium octamolybdate was left over, so I filtered the solution quickly and washed the filter with about 20 milliliters of boiling hot acetone. The resulting slightly yellowish turbid acetone solution of tetrabutylammonium hexamolybdate was placed in a freezer overnight, and small yellow crystals of the product formed. The next day, these crystals were filtered off and washed with about 50 milliliters of ice-cold acetone. Thank you. After a brief drying to remove any acetone, the mass of the final product was 1.63 grams, or about 35.45%. Probably the reasons for the poor yield include the messy recrystallization I carried out and the fact that I did this reaction on twice the scale of the original paper. Anywho, thanks for watching and have a great day. Bye!